Okay, so yesterday I told you about some arithmetic operators, right? So I told you about plus, minus, then division, multiplication, and exponential. Can anybody tell me what plus is used for? I think everybody knows this. What it is used for? It is used to add two things, right? It is used to add two numbers. Similarly, minus is used to subtract two numbers. Division is used to divide two numbers. Star is used to multiply two numbers, and it is used to give power. Right? I think it's clear to everyone. It's not that hard, right? If I'm adding two numbers like that, I can subtract two numbers. It is used for division. And then star is used for multiplication. And then this is used to give it the power. So I think this much is clear to everyone, right? I might have started. It's not recording. It's recording. I've just started recording. Thanks for making me remember. But I have started it. So I hope these arithmetic operators are clear to everyone, right? Are these clear to everyone? Then I told you about some basic functions in Excel that are sum. So what sum is used for? Sum is used to do sum only. So you to use it, first we have to do a equal to sign, then use sum, and then we need to give the number. So I'm dragging these numbers because I want to have their sum. So that's how I can have the sum. Similarly, we have average. Same thing I'll do for average also. Drag the numbers of which I want the average. That's how I can get the average. I have count function also to have the count of numbers. Then I have median, min, and max. Median is used to give the median of the numbers. Then we have a max. It will give the maximum value among all these numbers. And then we have min. It is used to give the minimum value among all these numbers. So if I changed any value here, like if I changed it to 19 or 18, then you can see all those numbers are changed. Right? If I do any changes anywhere, then the changes in the formula will also occur. If I use 34 here, you can see everything will be changed. Okay. Is it clear to everyone? Okay, so let us use there. So their selling price is not written. Give me a sec. Let me put some selling price here. Okay, so here I want to find the total of buying price. How I'll find the total of buying price? Yeah, by using sum. So I'll just use sum and just drag the values that I want to sum off. That's how I can get the sum of buying price. Similarly with selling price also, just use sum and you can get the sum of selling price. Okay. Can anybody tell me how you get to know that I got a loss or a gain? Can anybody tell me how you know that I got a loss or a gain? By subtracting selling price from a buying price, right? If my selling price is greater, then that means that I have a gain. Yeah, right. So I'll do that same. I just subtract from my selling price and I'm subtracting my buying price from my selling price, and you can see I'm getting minus 2. So if I get a value in minus, what that mean? That here loss is happening. So I'm dragging till the value I want to have. Is this clear? I got a minus here, like I got the value in negative. That means loss is happening here. That to everybody know, I guess. So what I am doing, I'm just subtracting my buying price from my selling price. If I get value in negative, that means loss. If positive, then me that means profit. I hope this much is clear. So now, how we will find the fractional cost? So to get the fractional cost, we just need to get the fractional cost, what we need to do, we have to divide buying price of an item with total buying price. So we will do the same here. Buying price of an item divided by total buying price. See, I got an answer. But if I drag it down, I'm getting a division error. Can anybody tell me why am I getting that division error? You explained that thing yesterday also. Can anybody tell me why am I getting that division error? Yeah, because I haven't fixed the row. So let me tell you why I need to fix the row. As you can see, when I drag it down, the rows are getting down also. Here we have B2 and B6, but when I drag down here, we get B3 and B7. But we want here B3, but here we want to have B6, right? So the simple way to do it, like I don't want to change my row. So in front of row, I'll just put a dollar sign. Let me explain it again. So as you can see, I was getting a division error. So to fix a row, for example, we have B6 only. So to fix a row, we have to put the dollar sign before the row. To fix the column, we have to put the row, dollar sign before the column. And to fix both of these things, we need to put dollar sign before both, before column as well as row. Any confusion to anybody? Any confusion to anybody? Okay, tell me what's the meaning of this? What's the meaning of this? Yeah, I have freeze the column. If I put dollar sign before both, then I freeze my column as well as my row. Right, I freeze myself. Okay, so that's what I'm doing here. Can anybody tell me the formula for fractional sale? It's same as fractional cost only, similar to it. Can anybody tell me the formula for fractional sale? Answer me in the chat box, guys. Yeah, right. Which thing I have to fix? Write that also. So, to get the fractional sale, I just have to get the selling price of an item divided by total selling price. And what I need to fix is I want to fix the row because I don't want my row to go down. So I'll drag it and can get the value. I hope these things are clear to everybody. So now I'll tell you about if statement. So what if is? So if, then inside the if we need to give. Let me explain it here only. So I want to comment whether I get a loss or gain. So I'll use a if statement. So what if here we can see I'm getting a logical test. So how I'll know whether I have done a profit or whether I have done a loss? When my number is in negative, that means that I have a loss, right? If my number is a negative, that means I have a loss, right? Yeah. So what if does? First, we have to write the logical test. So here I'm writing that if my D2 is greater than zero, then I want to give what if my statement is true, then if my number is greater than zero, is it be profit or is it be loss? Is it be profit or is it be loss if my number is greater than zero? It's profit. So I'll write profit. And when it's false, then I want loss. So here you can see I got loss. Right? If I drag it down, you can see positive value will have a profit. Let me explain it again. So inside if condition, first we have to give the logical value. Logical, any like what logic I want to create. If my value is true, then I have to give the true value. Like if my value is true, then what I want to give there. Here I have given profit. And if it's loss, then I want what? Like if it's false, then I want the false value. Is it clear? That's how we use if statement. Okay. So here also what I want is if my selling price is greater than buying price, then I want to give continue as I want to give non-continue, not continue. Write in the chat box about that answer. How will I be able to do it? Not continue. Right, with the help of if statement. Like if my selling price is greater than buying price, I want to give continue, else I want to give not continue. Write in the chat box. I'm looking forward for everybody's answer. If anybody want me to explain it again, I'll do so. Write in the chat box. I want to give a statement like if my buying price is greater than selling price, then I want to give not continue, and if otherwise I want to give continue. Write in the chat box. I'm not getting any answer. Yeah, only one answer I got. Yeah. Just write with the help of if statement. Yeah, right. Okay. So I'm using if, then we have to give a logical test. What I want is if my selling price is greater than my buying price. I want to give there. Continue. Else, I want to give. Not continue. That's all I have to do. As you can see, my selling price is smaller than buying price. That's why I'm getting not continue here. And other, I'm getting continue because my selling price is greater than my buying price. I think this much is clear to everybody. Okay. So I'm moving forward to my next sheet. Now I'll tell you what concat is. So what concat is? Concat help me to join two or more strings. So if I want to join these two strings, I can join it with the help of concat. I'll just choose my string and then concat. Do you get it? What concat is? It helped me to join two or more strings together. Helps me to join two or more string together. Any confusion to anyone? Do you get it what concat is? Okay. So let me tell you about left and right. So if I want the first name with a form with the help of a left formula, then I'll use left. So what I want is I want the first name. First name of this Nishant Shukla. How can I get it? I'll just use left and after left, because I want left corrected, that's why I'm using left. So after left, what I want is I want to give the text. And after that, I want to give how many numbers of character I want. So how many numbers of character I want to have the first name? Tell me in the chart box. How many characters I want to have to get the first name? Only one person has answered me. Yeah, seven. So if I'll close it, you can see I got Nishant. But if I drag it down, you can see other people, like here also you can see I'm not getting the first name. I'm getting Udit's. The first name of Udit is Udit only, right? Yeah. And here also you can see in Abhishek, I'm not getting the full name because I have just taken seven characters from my left. So what I can do is there is one function called find. So what find is used for? Find is used to find some text. So here what I want is I want to find the space. So I'll just write space. And in which text I want to find the space? In that text I want to find the space. So I'll just close my bracket. And that's eight, right? So what I will write there, how many characters I want? I want the characters till my space. So I'll just write here, find my space in what character in Nishant. So if I'll close it, you can get it. Here I forgot to put the comma. I got Nishant here. Now if I drag it down, you can see all answers I got are correct. Yeah, we have to give the condition to stop before the space. That's why we used find. Any confusion to anyone? Do anybody want me to explain it again? It's little confusing, I know that. Okay, let me explain it one more time. So I want to find first name in this. So to find the first name, I want the characters from the left. So I'm using a left function here. So first I have to give the text. So I'm using this text. And how many numbers of character I want? So I want the character till my space, right? I want the character till my space, right? After Nishant, I have a space now. Answer me, yes or no, answer me in the chat box. till space I want to have the characters. So what I'll use? I'll use find. And inside find, I'll give that I want the character till my space. And within which text? In this text. I'll just close it. And now you can see I got my answer. Is it clear to everyone? Okay. Similarly, we have a function called write. So, what I want is I want the last name with the help of write. Can anybody tell me in the chat box how I will be able to find my last name with the help of write? I want to find my last name. I want to find Shukla here. How I will be able to find it? Answer me in the chat box, everyone. So let me explain. So I'm using right. No, wrong, Dhruv. So first I have to give the text and then number of characters from the right side, right? How many characters we want from the right side? In Shukla, how many characters we want? Wrong, wrong. How many characters we want from the right side? Yeah, we want six character. How you get that six? How you get that six? That from the right side, I have six characters. You get that six by subtracting the length of this with the space. Within what text? This. Do you get it? Should I explain it again? So let me copy it here first. So what am I doing is, wait a minute. Let me write my name, Pragya Rathi. Here what I want is, I want the last characters. How can I get the last number of characters? By subtracting my full name, by subtracting my full name, if I subtract, okay, from this, how I'll get the last character? By subtracting my first name from my full name, right? If I subtract my first name from my full name, can I get Rathi? Yes, right? So to get the whole name, what function I'll use? To get the whole name, I'll use length. And to get the first name, till the space. I want the numbers till the space for my first name, right? So I'll use find here. Till what? Till space. In my Pragya. Is it clear? How I get Rathi? Is it clear? So I'm using same thing here also. So here, after using write, so how we so how many characters I want? I want the length of my Nishant subtracted from the till the space. Number of character till the space. So I'm using that only that I explain till the space and Nishan. So now you can see I get Shukla, similar for everyone. Anyone want to explain me again? I know it's little difficult, but you will get it as soon as you practice. Will you be able to find it yourself? Okay, let me explain again. See, Khushbu, if I use Pragyarathi. So, how many characters Pragyarathi have? Tell me in the chat box, Khushbu, how many characters does Pragyarathi have? So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll count space also. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 characters are there. Space is also counted. So how I'll get the length of my last name? How I'll get the length of my last name? If I'll subtract, tell my space. If I subtract the length, tell my space, will I be able to get the last name? If I'll subtract, tell my space. If I'll subtract Pragya from my name, will I get Rathi? Khushbu, I'm asking from you. If I subtract, tell that space. You can see the space between Pragya and Rathi. If I subtract, tell the space, then I can get Rathi, right? And to get the length, tell the space, what function I have to use? Write in the chat box. To get till the space, like number of characters till the space, what function will I use? I'll use find. So what I have to find? I have to find space in which text? In my Pragyarathi text. So that's what I have to use. And to get total number of characters, I'm using length of my Pragyarathi. So that's what I am using here also. Here also I'm using the same. So I'm using the write function. So first I want to give the text, then I want to give number of character. So from my full name, I just want to subtract the value till the space. Till the space. Same thing I'm doing here also. You can see I get Shukla here. Any confusion to anybody? Is it clear to you, Khushbu, now? Okay, I'll explain that also. How do I find the middle name? Let me move forward, then I'll explain. Okay, first tell me what formula I use to have my first name, right in the chat box. What formula I use to have my first name, right in the chat box. Everyone. I want answer from everybody. How I get my first name right in the chat box? Use left function. Yeah, write full syntax. Those who are writing left, write full syntax. Yeah, right. Right. Okay. Upesh, why did you write that? Why did you subtract find C2 minus find space C2? Should I unmute yourself to overcome your confusion? Okay, it's by mistake. Okay, how I find my last name? Write that also in the chat box. Then we will move forward to mid name. How I'll find my last name with the help of write? Write in the chat box, everyone. I'm looking forward for everybody's answer. Write in the chat box. Yeah, yes, right, Rupesh. I want your answer also, Khushbu. Yeah, right, because right there in them. So let me explain you about the mid name. Well, you can find the mid name. Okay. Can anybody solve this? Like, how will I be able to find the mid name if I have this name? Can anybody, like, anything you have in your mind, you want to solve it? Like, how will I be able to find? Yeah, we have a mid function. Without mid function, I'm talking about. With the help of left and right. I just told you about left and right functions, no? So how you will be able to find the mid name with the help of it? Any answer to anybody? Okay, I'll tell you. Okay. If from Pragya, if I find the last name with the help of right. No, I'll tell. So if I get the last name in Pragya with the help of my right function, right, then my text, then length of this text, comma, minus find space in this. What I get it? Okay, some mistake is there. Let me check it. Right. Then I use this fine. Okay. I have used single inverted comma. I got Singrati here, hai na? I got Singrati, right? But what I want is, I want Sing from this, right? So if I use left again, in this, if I use left in this text, and then what I want is, I want to find the character till the space, comma, here. I got Sing. Let's combine both these things together. So first, I want Singrati. So in left inside, which text I want to use? I'm using right here, then the text, then length of my this minus find what I want to find. I want to find space, comma, in which text? In this text, comma. So that's how I get like the text I want from this text, how many characters I want to have. So I want to first find the space. In which text I want to find this space? I want to find this space in this text. Let me copy it. V, this text. And if I'll close it, one bracket is missing. So find this. Right. Okay. Find space. In which text? In this text. Okay. I like 1, 2, 3, 1. It's closing. Let me see what wrong I did there. Find this. Okay. I did something wrong. So I want to find the space in my this text. Let me copy it. See, Control V. Let me write it again. It's a long formula, so maybe I did some mistake. So first I'm using left. Inside left, I'm using a right function to get Singrati here. So I'm using meters text. So length of this minus find the space of which character of this only. Then, okay, so closing it. Then, how many numbers of characters I want? I want the number of characters with the help of find till the space. I want the number of characters. And in which thing I want it? So I'm copying it. Control C. Control V. 1, 2, 3. 1, 3. So I got Singh here. Is it clear to everyone? I know it's little difficult, but is it clear? If anybody want me to explain again, I'll do so that, or I'll do so too. Okay, let me keep the formula visible. Is it visible? Yeah, it's so long. It's really simple. Let me explain again. So from Pragya, what I am getting, firstly I'm getting Singrati with the help of right, then I'm using left to get the Sing. The things that I told you with the help of first name and last name, that's all I'm doing here also. First I got Singrati with the help of my right function, and then I'm getting Sing with the help of my left function. I just combined both of these things together. Will not you will no one is going to ask you this thing in interview. I just explained it because one person has asked me. Okay, is it clear? Should I move forward? If yes, then let me know in the chat box. Okay. So if you can see here, I don't have a last name, right? 1 minute. If I have a name called Akansha here, and I'm using the same formula, left to get her first name, you can see I'm getting a value error, right? You can see that value error because in Akansha we don't have any space, that's why I'm getting a value error. So how we can solve it? To solve this error, I'm using if error. So what if error does? If error, in place of the error, it will give the value that I want to give. So in place of error, what I want to give? I want to give Akansha only. If my error is there, I want to give Akansha, right? So I'm getting Akansha. Let me explain it again. So if you divide anything with zero, it will give you a value error. It's giving a division error, right? So how we will use it? So if error, in place where we are getting the error, it will just remove that error with the value that we are giving. So I'm removing this error with zero. So here we were getting the value division error. So now we will get zero here. Is it clear? What if error does? Where we have error, then it will give us the value we have written. Okay, so we are doing the same. What we will do for last name? I'm getting a value error here also. So what we will do for last name, how we will use if error here. If we don't have a last name, I want a blank, right? So I'll just put a blank. I want nothing. I want nothing. Is it clear? Is if error clear to everyone? Okay, let me show the formula. Which formula you want to see? For last name or for first name? Let me show for both. Okay. In where I am getting the error, I want a space here. Okay. So moving forward. Okay. Hello, am I audible? Okay, so I think this much is clear to everyone. Is this much clear to everybody? Okay, good, good. So let us move toward nested if. I just told you about if. Do anybody remember what I told you about if? I told you about if, right? What I told you about if, write in the chat box. Yeah, what I told you about if. Yeah, it's like when our value, first we will write the value, and if my value is true, then what value I want to give? If my value is false, then what thing I want to give? That's what it does. Is it clear? Here also I've written. Yeah, right. 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 Okay. So for example, we have some marks of students. I'm writing some random marks. 10, 9, 8. 7, 6, and 5. So those who have marks greater than 8 has A grade. Greater than 8 has a A grade. Let me change it to general. A grade. Those who have greater than 6, I want them to give a marks B. Between 6 and 8, I want to give them B. And those who have marks greater than 5, here C, others D. So how we will do it with the help of if? Let me tell you that first. So if under this first we have to give the logical test. So what we are giving, if my value is greater than 8, then what I want to give? If my value is greater than 8, what I want to give? I want to give A there. But if it's false, then I'll give the logical operator again. I will use if again. So if my value is greater than 6, then I want to give B. Else, I'll use again if If my value is greater than 5, then I want to give what? I want to give C there. Else I want to give D. 1, 2, 3. So if I drag it down, you can see I'll get the values. Can anybody tell me how I did it? Do you get it? How I do did it? Can anybody tell me how I did it? No, I haven't used nested if. I'll tell you about ifs. Okay, do anybody want me to explain it again? I'll tell you with the help of ifs also. You can see the formula. Yeah, we have used condition under condition that is known as nested if only. So, do anybody want me to explain it again? Do you get the formula how I write it? Okay, if you get it right in the chat box. If you get it right in the chat box, what formula we have used? What formula we have used right in the chat box? Right in the chat box. The numbers which are greater than 8, I want to give them A. Which are greater than B, I want to give them. Which are greater than 6, I want to give them B. Then which are greater than 5, I want to give the C there. And then D. Write in the chat box what formula I used right now. If you get it, you can write yourself also. Do you want me to explain it again if you didn't get it? Do you want me to explain it again? Okay. So what I want is, see Rupesh, the numbers which are greater than 8, which are greater than 8, I want to give their A. Those which are greater than 6, I want to give their B. Which are greater than 5, I want to give their C. Other, I want to give D. Okay? Yeah, right, Rajat. So I'm using same. So how I'll get it? I'll write if. Under if, I'll use the logical test. So my first logic is if this is greater than 8, then what I want to give, Rajat? If my number is greater than 8, what I want to give? A, right? Otherwise, I'll give one more if. If my number is greater than 6, then I want to give what I want to give B. And then if my number is greater than 5, I want to give C there. And if not, then D for everything. So 1, 2, 3, 3 closing bracket. So that's how I get A. If I drag it down, you can see I get you 8 is not greater than 8, so B here. 5 is the smallest one, so I'm getting D there. 5 is smaller than 5, that's why I'm getting D. If I change the number here, if I change it to 4, grade will also change. Is it clear? Is it clear to everyone? Okay. So similarly, we have a formula nested if. If we have something called ifs. I just told you about nested if. I'll tell you about ifs now. As you can see here, we have to write if again and again. That's why our formula become too long, right? If I write something less than zero, let's try it. If I write something minus one, I get D there. Because minus one is smaller than five, no? I get D there. Is it clear, Dhruv? Right should be invalid. Minus one is greater, minus one is smaller than five, no? Minus one is a number. Why I'll get invalid? Marks cannot be minus five, but how will Excel know that I am just writing the marks? How will Excel know I'm writing the marks? I can write anything here, no? I just take an example of marks. Okay. So here you can see if I use nested if, I have to use if again and again, due to which my formula become too long and it's difficult to get through like how many bracket I have to use at the end, right? Right, yes or no? So there is something called ifs. What ifs do? Ifs will let me to write multiple logical operation once. How we will use it? Let me tell you that. First, if the statement is true, then what value? So if this is true, I want to give A. Then I'll give logical test 2. If this, here I forgot to write greater than A. So now my logical test 2, if this is greater than 6, I want to give here. What I want to give? I want to give here B. Then logical test 3, if a second, if this, let me make this broad a little. Let me broaden it first so that I'll be able to see the values. Let me write here itself. If E21 is greater than 5, then what I want to give? I want to give D there. And other value, those which are smaller than this, I want to give there D. Right? I want to give there D. Same thing. Do you get it? Any confusion to anybody? Okay. C, I wrote D there. Any confusion to anybody? Corrected it. I wrote C there. Ifs is same as if, but just we don't need to write condition again and again. We don't need to write if again and again. That's why we use ifs there. And we don't need to write any false condition here. What do you want to ask, Rajat? If anybody have any confusion regarding that, kindly ask. C should come in. Okay. Here C and here D. Okay. Got it. Now is it fine? By mistake, I have written. Is it fine now? Okay. Any confusion to anybody? Do you get it? What if and if this? Okay. So, giving you one question. So, I'm writing some number. So, if my number is greater than 60, I want to give best. If it is greater than 40, then I want to give better. Else I want to give good. Write in the chat box how I'll be able to do it. This is the question for everyone. Write the answer in the chat box. The number which are greater than 60, I want to give best there. If it's greater than 40, I want to give better. And other, I want to give good. I want everybody's answer. What is 20, Khushbu? Why have you written 20? I'm not getting you. Can you please explain me? What have you written 20 and 30D? So these are the numbers. What I want is the number which are greater than 60, I want to give best there. And the number which are greater than 40, I want to give better there. And other, I want to give best. Yeah, right. One person has answered me. So let me explain it. We will use ifs. Under ifs, we will give the logical test. No, Pushpu, I just told you the question. You have to write the answer. The things that I explain you right now. So what we will do is we will use ifs, and inside ifs, first logical operator I want to give is the thing. If it is greater than 60, what I want is I want to give good there. Then one more logic I want to give. So if it is greater than 40, I want to give better. Others I want to give. For others, what I want to give? I want to give good. So now you can see 23 is good, 45 is better, and 60. Here I have written good again. I have to write best here. Any confusion to anyone? Any confusion to anyone? I think everything is clear to you. Then we have something called SUMIF, COUNTIF, and AVERAGEIF. So, for example, we have some value. I'm writing some values here. One, two. So, I'm writing some values. Yeah, right. Anandam, right. So I'm writing some values here. I'll tell you how to use SUMIF. So for example, we want to sum only the things that are greater than. I want to sum only the numbers which are greater than 6. I just want to sum them. How I will be able to do it? First, I'll just select the range. Then I'll give the criteria. So what criteria I am giving? I want the numbers that are greater than 7. Close my bracket and I could get 77 here. Do you get it what SUMIF does? Yeah, similarly we have COUNTIF. First we want to select the range. Then after selecting the range, we want to give the criteria. So I just want to count the numbers that are greater than 7. So only 7 numbers are greater than 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 numbers are greater than 7. Similarly, we have averages. Averages. Then I have to select the range. Then I have to give, let me select the range again. Let me select the range. Then I will give the criteria. What criteria I want? Greater than 7. That's how I'll get the average. Is these things clear? Okay. So today I told you about, what are the things that I told you about? Today I explained you arithmetic operators again. Then I explained you sum, count, mean, median, these. Then after that, I explained you about left, right, how to get the first name, last name with the help of left, right function. I explained you how to get the mid name also, though that's not important, but still, it's better to know. Then I explained you ifs and nested if also. And then I explained you count if, sum if, average if, right? I think this much is enough for today. Today's I'm stop sharing. Okay. Okay, any confusion to anybody about today's lecture? Like, do you want me to explain something again? Any query? Okay, so I think if error is also clear to everyone. Okay, why we use if error, right, in the chat box?